Alright, this is our fourth grade orchestra. You're going to hear quite a difference from the third grade. The third grade, they were all playing the same note. Everyone was just playing this, the main melody. But now we're going to have some harmony here. So we still have violins, but we've split them. We have a violin one section, which is A through M. Raise your hand. It's violin one. Violin two is N through Z. Violin two. We have a viola section. We have a cello section, which is, by the way, this is the largest cello section I've ever had in fourth grade. These guys were amazing. Every one of them did a great job. And we also have two new instruments back here that we didn't have in the third grade. That's the bass. We have two bass players in our fourth grade, and it's great to have them. Gee, it looks like a Star Wars episode over there. Okay. All right. So we're ready to start. This is Old MacDonald, or Old Mac Fiddle. So you hear a little bit of Old MacDonald, but then you'll hear a little fiddle tune in there as well. And in fact, our bass players are going to kick this off with a nice little intro. So enjoy Old Mac Fiddle. The fourth grade, I think we had at least one was on the Practice Card Wall of Fame. So if you were on the Practice Card Wall of Fame, stand up. All right, great. And again, it's really great to see them get up on the Practice Card Wall of Fame. They get their name in the program, they get their picture outside the string room, and they get up on the wall up in the actual string room. So it's nice. So again, just pick a month from now until the end of the year and just see if you can try to get your picture up there on the Practice Card Wall of Fame. Did anyone do morning solos? Did a morning solo? Stand up. Let's give them a round of applause. Okay. And I think it's great that we do the morning solos because the second graders, first graders come in off the bus and there's somebody sitting there playing and they're just like, wow, they get to see it up close. And it really kind of lets them know that, hey, there's a string program here. It makes them aware of, you know, what we do with the orchestra. This next song is it's a medley of two songs. So it's the Holly and the Ivy, and then it goes right into Jingle Bells. So if you can hold your applause, we're going to do two songs. And this is in 3/4. It's probably one of the more challenging songs. But they really did a great job with this, and so please enjoy it. Finish our last song. I did want to acknowledge the fourth grade, the teachers as well. Between the specials teachers, the fourth grade, third grade, fifth grade teachers, and students coming out for their lessons, I realized that's difficult to have a schedule and put a schedule together and be pulling out of some classes. And they're really some of the most flexible folks that I've ever worked with. And I just wanted to acknowledge the teachers at McKnight. They're wonderful to work with. And without their help, without your help, and them practicing, it's like a trifecta, and without their help, it would be very difficult to have a concert like this. This is their last song, and they love this song. It's called Impulse. It's like an E minor, and it has this driving force, and has a kind of a scary sound to it. But please enjoy Impulse. Thank you. right, we have one more stage scene change here. If I'm a cello player, I'm gonna come around the front, fifth graders. Just fifth grade cello only. If I am a viola player, please let the violas come through. Violas, if you could enter over there. Fifth grade viola. Violas. Now listen. Okay, my last name is M for Z. Second violin parts, come on up, M for Z. Right in here. Good. And if my last name is A through M, violin, you can sit right up in here. You can make it really quick. I know you have third grade pictures, fourth grade pictures, but come on, you want to get a quick one?
Get a picture after it's done up.
He is in third grade. Plays one of the old ones. Thanks, Tony. I'll be right back.